back to action here on Headbangers Ball. We're about to, does this annoy you when I bang on the desk like this? If it does, tell me. We're just about to see a debut from a band called Trouble. Now, Trouble is out of Chicago. They've had three previous albums, Trouble, The Skull, and Run to the Blade. Now, if you're a Black Sabbath fan, which I am, and I know that you probably are, you can tell that Black Sabbath is definitely an influence for the band Trouble. First time I was ever on Headbangers Ball, which was last spring. Back in last spring, the first time I was on Headbangers Ball, I interviewed these guys, and they were right in the process of recording their last album, or the latest album, which is going to be a video that we're going to show you from the latest album. It's produced by Rick Rubin, who's produced a lot of rappers. He also produced Andrew Dice Clay, and Slayer, and Danzig. And this is the first video from Trouble. This is Psychotic Reaction. But check it out, it's April, right? It's kind of getting towards tax time. These are brand new boots. I just wore them on MTV. Now they're a tax write-off. See how that works? Maybe if I pull in my bike or something, then it was on MTV, and that'll be a tax write-off, too. I want to thank the Bad Brains for stopping by and kicking it on old Jennifer right here. But right now, it's time now for the Metal Detector. A little backup to some new news about AC/DC. They're back in a Dublin studio, and they're recording a follow-up to their Blow Up Your Video record. You see, everybody sounds like AC/DC right now. It's time to get the original AC/DC back and get a new album from there. Now, Angus and Malcolm's older brother, George, my older brother, George, that's what Liberace used to say, and I knew you knew that because all the headbangers like Liberace, right? Yeah, right. Well, their brother George is producing the album, and it looks like their drummer, Simon Wright, has left AC/DC and joined forces with Ronnie James Dio. Dio's album is due out in May, May 15th to be exact, and according to Dio, and I quote, it's more modern than the 1987 Dream Evil and a lot heavier and less commercial. Also in the Dio lineup are keyboardist James Johansson from Yngwie Malmsteen's band, and he's got a 17-year-old guitarist named Rowan Robertson. He's also got bass player Eddie Cook. Now, my idol, my fave, the Nuge. He just finished an album with Tommy Shaw, who I think was in Sixth or something like that, which I know is one of your faves. But anyway, Tommy got smart, man. He's playing with Ted Nugent and Jack Blades from Night Ranger. This is definitely going to be an interesting collaboration, the figures, the ninjas, and it's going to be cool. The band is called Damn Yankees, and here is one of my all-time favorite songs. Turn this one way up. Here's Cat Scratch Fever. Thank you. And you might have seen me in Breckenridge, Colorado, being like, the yuppie guy versus spring break, a guy that never went to college, talking about spring break. And then if you watch MTV News, I got to interview Aerosmith. I was like this MC that got inducted into this Rock Walk in Hollywood, and I got to meet all the guys in Aerosmith. Now check it out. This is really cool. I get to go somewhere, and you can come with me. It's called the MTV Headbangers Ball Contest, not faking it, in Japan. They're going to have to let me go to Japan, and they might even let you out there. Now, get a postcard, get a paper and a pen, or a crayon, better make it a pen, and don't use very many big words, and we're going to tell you a little bit later how to enter this contest. The deadline is April 3rd, I believe, April 3rd, and you and me are going to go to Tokyo, and we're going to see Michael Monroe. You know, I mean, Michael's the coolest, and Tokyo is cool, and like, I'm excited. I've never been to Tokyo, and you, out there, one of you is going to go to Tokyo with me. I'm excited. Do I seem excited? Do I stutter? Do I spit when I talk? Right now we've got a video. It's a debut video. You have never seen this one before, and you will see it now. It's from Power Mad, and it's called Nice Dreams. Thank you. also got a debut from the London Choir Boys, who are also really cool. If you like that Rod Stewart's early Stonesy kind of thing. And we have me. But there's also good reasons why to watch Headbangers Ball. And you'll see that next Saturday. And we're going to tell you more about that current event. We're going to go to Tokyo. I'm out of here. Until next week, I'm Ricky Rackman. Remember to keep one foot in the gutter, one fist in the goal. See ya. serious? Did I sound like Andy Rooney?
Do you ever wonder why all these bands are so serious about rock and roll these days?
I've also decided I've completely lost my mind.
Well, all these bands are coming out with all these, like, political things, and it's good to have a band come out with something that's, like, really funny.
Such is the case with this new band called Scatterbrain.
Now, they just released their debut album, and it's called Here Comes Trouble. Now, before you even open the album, you will notice that Robert Williams, who's the same guy that painted the original Guns N' Roses Appetite for Destruction album, which they took off the market because it was bad, and it'll make us do bad things. Well, he also drew Scatterbrain's album cover for this new record called Here Comes Trouble. Now, it's cool because it's like kind of comedy and kind of rock and roll. It's Metallica meets Cheech and Chong, as you could say. And they got, remember that song that Cheech and Chong did where he was dancing around like a ballerina? They also released a single called Earache My Eye, the one that goes, my mama talk a female title, tell me how to live. You get the idea? Well, they do that on it, and it's cool. Plus, they also perform a heavy metal rendition of Mozart's Sonata number 3. Now, Joe Satriani, that big guitar guy, said that was the most enjoyable rock and roll guitar classical composition he's ever heard. That's pretty good because, like, he's a good guitarist, right? Now, the rest of the songs on the album are all original numbers. Down with the Ship is, like, one of my favorites because it has all these different guitar licks from well-known tunes. A lot of Zeppelin ones. It's got Walk This Way from Aerosmith. It's got a part of Seek and Destroy from Metallica and even the Woody Woodpecker theme. It's kind of like about how all the songs that people are doing now kind of rip off everybody. Well, they just blatantly rip off everybody in that song. And they have a song called Don't Call Me Dude, which starts out like a 50s doo-wop song and tells a story of a guy who goes absolutely nuts when people call him dude. And Scatterbrain does have a serious side. For example, Out of Time deals with the horror of drug abuse. Definitely an album worth checking out. I like it. That's it for the Metal Detector. That's it for me whining and complaining. It's back to more rock and roll videos. Here's Babylon AD with Bango the Bell.
And now...
I'm gonna get you out.
James Dio. He had great toys. And he's the most inexpensive guitarist we could find.
Yeah, right. So instead of them having to go out and buy all the toys that I own, they figured, well, you know, at least if we could take him and have all the toys that we can find.
Yeah, buying video games and all that.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah.
Thank you.
Sabotage here. Now, we just saw a couple minutes ago in the video, Gutter Ballet. Mm-hmm. That's written about New York, right?
Yeah, definitely New York influenced.
And are you guys from, you're from Florida, right?
Well, he's from New Jersey.
I'm the only New York
but my brother and I, and the drummer, Mr. Wackel. Steve, how you doing? We were all born up here, and we were, lived here too, like in our early teens, and then we all moved away around the country and all ended up in Florida and met, somehow. Oh, God.
Now, I understand there are a couple of horror stories from the video recording of Gutter Ballet.
Oh, absolutely.
It was very cool.
Too how cold? The blue stuff on our face.
Yeah, the blue stuff is
real.
Face.
It's not light.
It's not makeup.
We're
actually as blue as
it was like
blue.
We picked the coldest day of the year. It was like -2, and with the wind chill factor, it was like 35 below 0.
That's Fahrenheit, not that European.
Yeah, it was definitely freezing, and we were doing it like midnight until 6 a.m. in Alphabet City. Beautiful place. Bring the wife, the kids. Do some time in the Big Apple, folks. I'm telling you. What a place. We had the junkies hanging out. Hey, man, give me $5, $5. It was kind of
awkward to the feel, shall we say.
Definitely inspired us, We had to be there, folks.
We want to thank you guys a lot for stopping by. It was a very swell, of course.
You like your show? My style.
Take you cheating. I'm back for a while.
Hold on.
Who's the best?
Very
love
that.
You have to be there.
But right now, we're leading into a kind of anti-war type video. This is Metallica with a video.
Isn't it very white?
This is Metallica with a video 1.
I know I want to see you.